Hello everyone, good morning. Let's solve a problem that is based on bromination. Question is, how many monobromination products would be obtained from the radical bromination of methyl cyclohexane? Ignore stereoisomers. Second part is, which product would be obtained in greatest yield, and we have to explain it. And the third is, how many monobromination product would be obtained if all stereoisomers are included. Now let's proceed. Methyl cyclohexane, and when we do the bromination, that is the Br2 in presence of HNO or heat, in the presence of sunlight or heat, then what will be the bromination product? Let's see. Monobromination product may be first CH2Br. The second, it can go to this tertiary carbon like this, and here it will form Br. The third, it can go to the respect to methyl, and then it can proceed to this position, and the last, that will be 1,4 product like this. So these are the 5 monobrominated product that we will get after the bromination. So these are the 5 different monobrominated products, excluding the stereoisomers. So this is the solution for the first part, and we have get total of 5 products. Now move to the second one. Which product would be obtained in greatest yield? Basically, we have to find which will be obtained in greatest yield. Now we know that the monobromination product, okay, is highly selective in nature. So the free radical corresponding to the tertiary carbon or this 3° will be most stable. That free radical will be most stable, and in the product corresponding to this, that is the CH3Br, this will be the most stable product, and this product will be obtained in the highest yield or the greatest yield. So it will be in highest yield. So this is the product that is we are getting in highest yield. And now the third part, how many monobromination products would be obtained if all stereoisomers are included? So basically we have to count. So now let's see. First, this is CH2Br. There is no chiral carbon, so only one product is obtained in that. Plus, in the second case, it is CH3Br, and again there is no chiral carbon. This is itself not a chiral because both these are equal. So again, only one product. The third one is CH3Br. In this way, we have 2 chiral carbon. One is this one chiral and this one chiral. So total stereoisomer will be 2 square equal to 4. Okay, now the fourth one is this one, CH3Br. So in this case, again there are 2 chiral, 1 chiral carbon and 1 chiral carbon. So it will be 2 square, that is 4, plus the last one is this one, CH3Br. Although it has no chiral carbon, no CH symmetric, but it can show GI, can show geometrical isomers, because when both are in same direction or opposite direction, so it can show the geometrical isomers. And again, it will have one cis and one trans, so total of two stereoisomers. So if you sum them, that is 1 plus 1 plus 4 plus 4 plus 2. If you add them, then the total number of the stereoisomers that we are getting is 4 plus 4 plus 2, 10, and 2, 12. So the correct answer for the part C is 12.